Next up is Peter Wilson performing Before the Throne, accompanied by Joshua on the drum kit. Give him a warm, warm welcome.
That's what you said when you was just like a song. When we were young, when we were young, when we were young, when we were young. It's hard to admit that everything just takes me back to when you were there, to when you were there. And a part of me keeps holding on, just in case it hasn't gone. I guess I still care. Do you still care? It was just like a movie. It was just like a song. My God, this reminds me of when we were young. Let me photograph you in this light in case it is the last time that we when we were young. We'll be right back. Thank you.
side most of that summer. In the street, the usual stuff.
I pops one, I pops two, I pops another.
And that meant me.
She was always it.
Running wasn't my strong point.
It made me laugh.
Skipping was. Cinderella dressed in yellow went downstairs to meet her fella. Hide and seek, knick knock,
football,
tennis balls, marbles,
roller boots,
elastics, anything at all.
Just normal.
Just what we knew. We would go messages.
It was a nice little earner.
Keep the change.
My mother said it was a good wee businesswoman.
Our best clients
at the time
lived in number 24.
Max and...
what was the other one's name?
Joseph!
They knew everything.
About everyone. The wicked witches of the East and West.
They always needed things.
From the shop.
What do they need now?
Let me think now.
What did they say they needed?
Maybe you should write your wee list, love.
I can know it's grandma's.
I'll remember. And if I don't, Emma will.
Ah, you're a good wee girl.
She's such a good wee girl, Josie.
She is, surely. She's a lovely girl. A lovely, well-mannered girl.
It's a miracle. Because when you look at that father of hers, if there ever was such an ignorant stack of pile. Get me fags as well, Maggie.
No water. But sure, first I've got to run to that tray at the back.
What tray?
Oh, you know, the one that all my money grows on.
Don't be such a tight old witch. I'll pay you back.
Sure, that's right, girls. Josie's waiting on a check coming in for a bit of modelling work she's been doing.
You should see these legs.
Aye, you just keep telling yourself that.
They're both dead now. They must be.
I heard Mags died first. My mum told me at the wake. Someone asked Josie if she took sugar in her tea. She said she didn't need it. Mags always made the tea.
Dennis O'Donnell's shop was brilliant.
Part news agent, part hardware, part chemist. As a shopkeeper, Dennis was a bit of a natural.
What the flip? Did I tell you about wearing them flipping roller boots and they flipping shit? What the flip?
I did a speedy service.
Am I running a museum here? Bye and go. Bye and go. Just looking doesn't pay my rent.
The thrill of stealing from O'Donnell's shop. Name the fact that if he caught you,
he would actually kill you.
We never got caught.
We were told Hyde would be criminal in his back garden. That's why roses grew there. Well fertilized soil.
We were clever than most.
It was pure luck, really.
We were always buying, you see, for Mags or Josie or someone else.
So while I was paying.
While I was paying.
She would stay.
She would stay.
She didn't need to. She always had the money.
I couldn't spend it.
I was so jealous.
Counting our taking from O'Donnell's shop is always a good way to spend the afternoon.
I know they're injured somewhere. Three packets of crisps.
I don't like cheese and onion.
It keeps salt and vinegar way too high up.
I know you keep them.
I can't cope.
Oh, lucky sod. A tomato.
Ugh, I hate tomatoes. You must feed that to the dog. The Daily Mirror.
My dad read that. A travel toothbrush.
At least you'll have minty fresh breath.
another freshener.
At least you'll have a minty fresh car. A packet
of water balloons.
No way.
Look, I thought he kept those behind the counter.
He does.
You're mad.
I'm brilliant.
But what if he'd have turned around?
But he didn't, did he?
You'd have been dead.
But I'm not. And I've got a packet of water balloons. When she wasn't there, I had others. My standbys, my last resort. There was her brother, Marty, and their cousin, Casper. But I didn't find either of them particularly stimulating.
So then I kicked the ball right up against the shop window, really hard. Like,
he did, right up against it. It nearly broke, so it did. The glass nearly broke. It was this close to breaking.
Pocket it, would you? This is my story. I'm Tom Stewart. So Dennis marches out. He was raging.
You should have seen his face. Absolutely raging.
Not this bat in his hands, but it wasn't a normal sized baseball bat. This one was massive.
Flippin' huge. Flippin' massive. He was gonna kill us.
Pack it in, would you? So then he shouts,
"Aye, did you just kick that ball against my window?"
And I goes, "Aye, I did. What are you gonna do about it, old man?"
"I'm gonna break both your flippin' legs, that's what I'm gonna do about it. You won't be playing football for a while, son."
And he starts coming at me with the bat.
"Aye. Oh, you wee."
He did. He ran at him with it. He took a swing at Marty, but he got a hold of it. Marty got the bat off him.
I got the bat. Broke in two, threw it at his feet. He says to him, "You'll not be doing much with that now, will you?"
"I swear."
"On my granny's grave."
The good old days when we were young and so innocent.
Good times.
Thank you. many spots.